Hey guys, welcome back to our weekly meal segment, and I hope this video finds everyone doing well and getting in the fall spirit, because the weather's sure letting us know it is fall and winter is almost here. So that is one of the reasons I got one of my comfort food, video that I had wanted to put up last year, but I didn't get a chance to put it up. And plus, I forgot it, guys. So, anyway, let me tell you what we have on the menu today. We have some smothered chicken with onion gravy, and it's delicious too, guys. And I have some rice. The rice look yellow, but it's not. It's regular fluffy rice with the gravy on top. Let me tell you a little bit about that rice, guys, because I know I'll forget it later on. My daughter-in-law got me started on that turmeric. Is that the name of it, Tuck? That turmeric?
Yes.
And I always sprinkle a little in my rice and other little dishes and stuff. It's good for AR. And, you know, I had it. Sometimes my wrists and stuff be letting me know. Girl, you're not young at all. Okay, and then, guys, I have some stir-fried snap beans with pimento and some bacon and onions in it. They're really good. And we're having just regular store roll with, I have the apple cake going on over there. And let me tell you something, guys, about the cake. You know, I told you in the other video I had the apple cake. And I told you guys how I put it in the freezer, how I wrap it individually, slice it up, and wrap it individually, and put it in the in a Ziploc freezer bag. I wrap it with a plastic wrap. And I put it in there, and then I just get us a couple of slices out of whatever. But this is the last of it. And I am so glad, because I have, I'm not glad, but I'm saying I'm not worried about it, because I have, the next video I put up probably would be the apple cake for you guys. Like, I think it's a fall cake, and I could just see somebody having it at their table for Thanksgiving. I don't eat so much. I don't know. I may bake another one. According if Brittany want one. But let me tell you something about this cake, guys. Tuck like eating it with ice cream, right?
Sure do.
And then he seen me having a slice with a coffee. I brought a little slice, and I should be having, but oh well, you don't live one time, and God says in his word, if his food he made it, he blessed it. You know, it's good. And I just don't need to overindulge it, but I have me a slice of that cake and with some coffee, and it is so good. I just love it. This cake is a good cake. It's going to be my go-to cake now.
That cake's good with anything. You can eat it by with just cake.
It sure is.
It's a good thing that I'm about gone, because I don't eat the majority of that cake, to be honest with you.
Oh, I've had my little share with them little smaller slices and stuff. I see you went around. That's what I be having. You see me with having it with the coffee. Yeah. That's what I be having. Then Tuck started having it with the coffee, too. I told him he was a copycat. And but let me tell you guys, I have this have the apples and the pecans in it. But I think when I do the video for you guys, I may put walnuts in it, because I got it in my head that I want to try it with some walnuts. So I probably will do it with walnut, but you can put either nut that you want, the pecan or the walnuts. But I think I'm going to put some walnut in this one. And I just love that cake. And you know who sent me, the person that sent me the recipe, you know who you are. I just appreciate it to the highest. That's what my channel is all about, sharing, caring, and sharing. Anytime you guys want to share a recipe with May May for her to try and stuff like that, I will definitely appreciate it. I like trying different things. That's just like one of my hobbies, like ceramic, trying different recipes. I get pretty excited about if it's a recipe that it sounds like something that, you know, that I like and interest in and whatever, or either something that I have always wanted to try but didn't have a recipe for it. And then, guys, okay, let me not forget, we got the sweet tea over there, because Chuck, I always remind me about to forget the tea. We got sweet tea for our drink, our beverage, or whichever one you want to call it. But, guys, we have already eaten, and I'm probably going to be eating again, because this is a delicious meal. It is a comfort meal, because I tell you what, I felt so good after I got finished eating, and I only ate just a small amount. I just really had to go ahead on and do that gravy and a piece of that chicken and rice right away. I haven't eaten snap beans. I'll do that with my meal later on. So, guys, it's not anything else that I can tell you about the meal. Did I cover everything?
I think so.
I think I got everything covered, and I hope that I did the gravy and stuff in the chicken and the gravy in enough details where you guys can get the gist as to how you make that gravy. Gravy is not hard to make, but you got to put it in your head what you're trying to achieve with any recipe. Okay, because, you know, I've seen people make gravy and don't make enough, you know. I'm like, that's not enough gravy. That ain't even no more than about a half a cup full. So that's when I showed you guys how the amount of flour that I was putting in there. Because if you want a big pot of gravy or whatever, you got to increase the amount of flour you have in there to thicken it up. Unless you know. Now, I know a lot of people make gravies different ways, but I made this the traditional landmark type way that style. You cannot go wrong with it. It is absolutely delicious, and it has that unique taste that you can't beat. And I showed you guys how to get that taste. What you got to pay attention to getting your flour. Don't go just putting all that flour over in there and not browning it off. Just take your time. It's not hard at all. Take your time to stir it around until that flour brown. Don't have your stove too high. So, guys, I explained this thoroughly in the video when I did it. So, I'm not going to go back into that. So, I just wanted to show you guys. This is one of my, I'm working on doing my fall table. And guess what? This may be it. Next time I do a weekly meal, I probably have my turkey over there to show you guys my turkey. And I got another turkey I'm going to show you, but I'm going to put up a little quick video on that sister, because she kind of big. And but anyway, I want you guys to stay warm. And I mean, dress warm. And then on those real cold nights, because we had some below, 37 degree weather around here, but it seemed like more like it was 20 something. And
that wind blowing with it, that's what make it feel colder.
And you know, I like my house all nice, warm, and toasty. So I was drinking me some coffee, just not for the fact of the leisure of it, a pleasure of it. I was drinking some coffee to heat my body up. I said, oh, I got to get this heater adjusted right, because it's cold in this system.
But you know what, Mamie?
What's that?
One good thing about down where we live, it don't last long. You may get a few days of it, or maybe a week or so of it. But next thing you know, the temperature is easing back up to more what we're used to in the season of temperature around this area, here into the 70s, and might get up in the low 80s or something like that eventually. But it's not unusual for us to have a 70s, 80 degree Thanksgiving Day, a Christmas Day here. Then the next day you may drop down to be in the 40s and 50s or even the 30s, like you say. But
when we was a little girl around Thanksgiving stuff, it got cold. It was cold and it stayed cold.
Yeah.
It was cold and stayed cold, because I loved it, the outside. And I was always outside, and my mama be saying, come in. You know, they would leave if you play outside too long in the wintertime, you would catch colds and all that. And the people know they really guarded us against cold. I've never seen colds and stuff like since I've gotten older. When I was growing up, I can't remember having too many colds. And I really hated whatever my mama told me not to do to catch a cold. Like, don't go out there. I mean, have yourself all bundled up around the neck and stuff like that. We did it because she would rub your chest down with some tallow. Oh my God. I think that's the reason I'm not a big beef fan to this day. That tallow, I think it was some kind of fat that came from the cow jawbone. Somewhere it came from the cow. I know, but it had that scent that just always would make me gag. And I was just like, I'll be about to get sick on it and all that. And so I just made sure I had in my mind, I don't want to catch no cold. Because that smell it just really sickened me. But okay, guys, and then another thing I was telling you, like, now, you know, around Thanksgiving, when we were growing up, it would be cold.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
you have icicles just about a hanging on the house.
Temperatures and everything certainly have evolved over the years with us around this area. Because yeah, you like you said, when we was youngsters and coming up, I remember when it got cold, it was cold
for
just about the entire winter and fall season. But now you may get a sporadic periods of it, a week, two, even every 4 or 5 years, you mean get a little bit of snow or stuff down here for a few days, but we all take it in stride. I mean, it's all part of what we enjoy about this part of the country.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. We still have fall, winter, and summer, maybe light or whatever, but don't get like some of these people playing God, Mother Nature, that they can adjust the weather by the cows not passing gas and cars not running fossil fuels and all that damn nonsense. I know people, my subscribers on this channel my age, I know you get a good laugh at them people like I do. I say, but the old people used to say back then, it's going to come a time that man going to try to out-know God. If they think in their head that they can do anything about a climate change, oh my God, I know I probably won't never live to see it. And then, you know, they done told us how long we got to live and all that. It's just funny to me that people actually buy into it. I mean, the younger people really buy it. I said, they must don't have no older people at their house to tell them, if you don't go somewhere with that nonsense and get away from here acting like you can change the weather. They talking about it's getting hot. I heard some other grown people say, well, you know, it's getting hot. Like, well, they done cut a lot of trees off the earth, and probably around you, they done cut a lot of trees off. So, you know, we used to have a lot of trees and stuff when we were growing up in the country. We was in the country. You couldn't see that. We had forests and stuff behind us. And so that must shield us from some of the heat when it should have been kind of warm. We were still kind of cold. So, okay, guys, I will see you all in my next video. I had started talking to y'all a little when I was doing my chicken dinner. I said, no, I talk to them when I do my weekly meal. That's when I like talking to you guys. But, okay, guys, you send me a video. I mean, send me a comment on whatever you want. Send me a comment on. Share out my videos. Remember to share out my videos. I thank the ones of you that had started letting the commercials and stuff play out. I see a difference in it. And then I had a lady to send me one of the most wonderful emails to the, you know, just, it was just beautiful, just kind-hearted person, and telling me that she didn't really know, so she just really wanted to do something for me. And then when I had told about letting the commercials pay that play, because that's the way us content providers, that's how we get our revenue. And she said that she will start doing that, not skipping over the commercial, which YouTube shouldn't have that, what can do that anyway. But she said that, and I can just for me, that this one person probably make a difference. Not only with me, guys. I know you should probably say, they may worry about yourself. They ain't worried, the other ones ain't worried about you. But any content provider out there, whether it's a child or grown-up or whatever, we put a lot in these videos, whether you know it or not. We put a lot in our videos and everything. And we, you know, and a lot of us get fun. We become just so fond of our fans and stuff. It just seems like a real, it's just like y'all is my family member. I just, the ones that I, you know, reply back to in the comments and stuff. When I see you come in, I'd be so eager to read it and all that kind of stuff. But it is getting where I can't hardly, you see, Maymay can't keep up with them comments like she was. at 5 o'clock in the morning when I used to get up and answer a lot of comments. These little bit of senior citizens' eyes still be kind of closed for a few minutes, about 30 more minutes longer. But like I say, I appreciate you doing that. And like I say, not only for me, any of the channels that you guys watch, don't skip over their commercials. You know, that's just, it's really not fair to get, they do that. It's not like we getting a mint doing these. Well, I don't put it like that. I don't. But I just love doing it and want to continue to do it. So, that's all I have to say about that, you guys. But I did have to thank you guys because I see that y'all did. You is letting my commercials play out because we have analytics on there that can tell us what's going on. And you guys are, I said, my crotch, they show up and show out. They are playing my commercial. Thank you, Jesus. I give you all the praise and the glory. So, guys, me and Tuck going to sign out. We about don't want to leave you. Yeah. See, I guarantee Tuck had got so covered with the conversation. So, but we going to get on off. And I'll be seeing you guys and chatting with you in my next video. And you know you always in May prayers. You part of my prayers at night. God, watch over us. We are all over the world, but I'll be praying for you. And hope God meet you at whatever your needs is. And the ones that having a little health problem, I hope you're mending well. So, guys, I will see you in my next video. Share out my video. And bye.
Bye.